Hi, I'm Adriana Baranek, you're watching this channel. I'm CEO of Media Group, and here with me is Mladen Baranek, our CTO. So this is a series, your email server and getting to know it, the UseWise feature. Today we will be talking about MX records. It sounds mysterious. What are MX records, Mladen? Can you tell us, please?
So MX records are mail exchanger domain name system records.
Mm-hmm.
That means that you can ask this public service, domain name service, about names of your mail exchangers, of your mail servers.
Mm-hmm.
And that is publicly available information. So if you are using your business email, anyone who would like to send an email to you have to ask domain name system where is your mail server, and in most cases there will be one or more mail exchange records that will point where a mail towards your business domain has to be sent. So it is very bad practice, and we see it with some business emails, that if there is no MX record specified,
mm-hmm.
then a sender will fall back and see whether you have an IP address specified for mm-hmm. your web server, and the email will be sent towards your web server, which is very bad practice.
Mm-hmm.
So as a bare minimum, we expect that a professional business email will have at least two or more mail exchange records.
Mm-hmm.
In case that one mail server is down, you can specify many servers so that the others can take over.
Mm-hmm.
Since today mail is one of crucial tools for many business processes, our tool will check and will show you what are your current mail exchange records,
mm-hmm.
and will give you a qualification whether they are set
mm-hmm.
up okay or not.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so MX records are basically just records that tell everybody that is sending email to your domain where this email will go, and this is a public record, so this is not something that is not known.
Yes.
It has to be known, because if somebody wants to send you an email, they have to know the system, the internet, world wide web, everybody needs to know where to send this email. And for instance, I can just put a computer here, I can just take a domain, I can have a fixed IP address, and basically I can use my poor old server at home or in my office as a mail server. But that is not a very good idea. So
no.
There are many bad ideas regarding the MX records, and the reason why we will have this tool on UseWise is so that if your company is using or has MX records wrongly configured, or has some other problems, or if you're using some outdated system or some outdated way in which your email is handled, so that you can just print it out and go to your IT manager and say, hey guy, this is really not how it should be. We should seek information from somebody that knows how to solve this for us. We want UseWise to be a place where you can come for advice. We want UseWise to be a place where you can come for all the public cloud services. We want UseWise to be a place where you can find information that you need. And we want to make it as easily and as automated as possible at any given moment. So this is the second video in our series. See you very soon. We will have other interesting topics on our UseWise channel. Thank you, Mladen, so much for your time today, and we will see you soon.
Have a nice day. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.